George.
I ain't no young.
Okay. So we have
young at all.
George.
Announcements?
Smoke is good.
Oh, I have one. Okay, Sarah has one.
Sarah? We are calling a women's caucus on Saturday at noon here in the park. So for women who are involved and want to talk about what your experience is as a woman, part of the occupation, and share in that way. We're going to do a like picnic potluck sort of thing here at noon.
Tomorrow.
Women's caucus,
noon,
Saturday,
tomorrow,
potluck. Okay. Is there any other announcements? Yes. Might not draw 11 scarves. Or anything like that.
Thank
if somebody needs one, please.
Thank you.
Thank you.
There are also gloves, hats, and socks.
Over there in the supply tent.
Okay, one
more. Any other announcements?
Media, if you want to be on the receive emergency text messages in the case of one, email media at OccupySIVA with your cell phone number, or you can do it on the website on the sidebar. We also have a newsletter that's sent out once a week. If you want to be added to that, email your email to media at OccupySIVA.org, or let somebody know, or let me know, and I'll do it for you.
Thank you, Zach.
I have one announcement. I put it up on the board, but 9 o'clock next Wednesday, people are getting together at the Miller Center to protest Dick Cheney's visit here in Charlottesville. And the night before Tuesday at 8 o'clock, there'll be people up at Random Row, I guess, talking about what they're going to be doing.
Nice.
So,
thank you.
An action. Woohoo! Random Row next Tuesday night at 8 o'clock. There'll be people getting together to talk about, I guess, how they're going to do what they're going to do. But 9 o'clock, they're going to congregate in the Miller Center, because nobody, apparently they don't like me because they turned me down for tickets, so think about that. But
I don't make enough money.
Probably, and you know, I wasn't on the donor list. So anyway,
so it's 9 o'clock the next morning?
They're getting together, because he doesn't speak until 11.
Okay.
So I guess, you know, to start getting there and getting set up and start yelling and whatever they're going
to
do.
So he speaks at 11?
He speaks at 11.
Great, thank you.
Inside. We'll be outside.
Yes, Brent.
All right, another announcement, just a reminder. This Sunday at 3 p.m., the reporters from the Echo who made all those nifty signs out there are organizing a march. We're meeting right here, marching through town.
Nice.
Bring your own sign if you've got it. If not, we'll give you one.
When is this again?
It's Sunday at 3, and there's another one Wednesday at 4, and the plan is to hopefully make it a regular thing those days at those times.
Okay, got it. Okay, great. Anyone?
I promised them I'd hype that again. So.
Right.
Oh, this Sunday at 1, we're going to have a public forum on the future of this space and the nature of public space and free speech and what we could possibly do to continue a presence here or at least explore those possibilities. We would probably meet up here, and we're attempting maybe to get a room with the library and move over, maybe move over to there and discuss it there. That'll be this Sunday at 1 p.m., am I correct?
Yes.
Yeah,
nice.
1 p.m. this
okay.
Sunday. So,
great, thank you.
We'd love to have all there and bring ideas and input on this whole question of the nature of speech and expression in public spaces and how we can, in this particular case, in this space, how we can continue that, make that an ongoing thing.
Great. Thank you, Frank. Thank you. Okay. Anyone else?
Yes.
This is Cheney. I heard you about the times. Does this information show up on the website?
It's all there. If you go on the Facebook website, and I think also on the calendar,
online.
Do we put these things up on the bulletin board also?
Yeah, there's a calendar.
There is a calendar there too, and if anyone wants to do that, they will double make sure it's there.
I just heard requests from people at different meetings.
Sure, to make sure it's here as well.
The Cheney thing is up there. So.
But first of all, did you pray to God?
Yes, we all have.
When? Just do it then.
I had a sign. Let's pray together.
Isn't there also one more announcement, another Virginia organizing event, Bank of America protest tomorrow? I'm not sure of the time. I've heard some different times. Does anybody know?
About what?
about tomorrow? Okay.
No, I'm sorry.
What is tomorrow?
Tomorrow's Saturday.
Oh, what's the nature of that event? I'm sorry.
It's Virginia Organizing. It's, you know, the bank protest.
Yeah, they're doing another
bank
protest.
Of America.
Oh,
yeah.
Well, we can, to be announced, we'll see if we can figure that out.
Yeah.
Thank you. Okay, anything else before we get started?
Yes, it is.
Do you have an announcement, Joe?
I got an announcement. I just announced how smart I am and how stupid I can't be. But, there's a whole lot of protests. I had a protest. Let's make it happen for real. Let's go just jack it, you know what I'm saying? Nah, I'm going to take it back.
Okay.
So much smoke in the area. My eyes is burning. But look, the only way to make food boil is to put it on that hot stove right there. But the only thing to make it happen is to boil some hot food. But as long as people can eat, as long as people got a place to stay, it's a lot of shit.
Okay, well, thank you, Woodrow. We'll keep that in mind. Is there anything else anyone else would like to say about an announcement before we get to the agenda?
They got to laugh. And I'm
no, it's good. Serious. Laughing is good. No, I can't. I'm very serious.
Okay, we got
it in the notes.
Oh.
Okay.
Agenda items?
Agenda items for today.
All right. Ashley.
The article in the Daily Progress.
Daily Progress article.
Okay, great.
Who else? Any other agenda items?
That's a pretty big one, so maybe...
I was going to say, I think there's a lot to talk about related to that article, and I almost feel like we should devote this whole GA to that.
I would second that.
Okay. Trigger fingers, everyone. Does anyone feel that we shouldn't, or are you going to block it? Is there anything other pressing that you'd like to talk about? Yes,
this is not pressing, it's a minor thing, but today is Friday, and family people were saying, can we have a meeting earlier, like 3 p.m.
On the weekend, we decided to be 1 o'clock, I believe. We decided that yesterday.
Oh, I'm sorry.
No, don't apologize. You're fine.
I forgot that I missed that.
That's okay. So let's say, obviously, you didn't know. It's great.
Sorry.
So, that's taken care of. So, the agenda for today is a response, or I guess we should perhaps talk about the Daily Progress article and also respond to it and see what we'd like to say, like, have a discussion over how we feel about it. And what it means to the rest of our stay here.
I can read it.
And Zach has volunteered
to read it. Does everyone know what we're talking about? What article?
If you haven't read it, it's probably a good idea if you hear it.
Do you want to read it?
Yes.
Yeah.
Don't need to read.
I'll go as fast as I can.
It's important.
All right, so it's written by the Daily Progress, published yesterday. Occupy fissures may lead to conflict with police, city government. A subgroup within Occupy Charlottesville wants a more confrontational direction for the movement, with some activists seeking a flashpoint in order to attract more people, according to an occupier who has played a key role in negotiations with city officials. There are a couple of people who want a confrontation, and they want to get arrested, and they want to use that as a tactic in this campaign, said occupier Evan Knappenberger, who was the first group member to sign for a special event permit from City Hall and the first to publicly address the City Council when the occupation sprouted in Lee Park nearly 4 weeks ago. Top Charlottesville officials have been operating under the assumption that the Occupy movement in Occupy Camp in Lee Park will likely end before the group's permit expires on Thanksgiving. But Knappenberger said he told City Police Wednesday that some of the younger activists might not willingly go quietly. The majority of those who want to stay past the permit simply don't want to see an end to what they've built in Lee Park, Number said, but they think getting arrested could help the movement. There are a couple of people who just want to get arrested because they see that working in other places to bring more people in. I don't think that's going to work in Charlottesville, said Knappenberger, 26. It does work sometimes. It worked in Oakland, it really did, but this is not Oakland. The Charlottesville police are not going to brutalize us. And even if they did, the Charlottesville media would not portray it in such a way that would really help us that much. After a clash in Oakland on October 25th resulted in 100 arrests and left an Iraq War veteran with a severe head injury, the city became a focal point for the National Occupy Wall Street movement, which has spawned similar groups in cities and towns across the country, all protesting against economic equality. Local occupiers consistently caution that nobody speaks for the entire group. Occupier Kaylee Kitchen, 25, said everyone involved has to make an individual choice about how far they're willing to go, but acknowledge that if it comes down to it, she'll likely stay and get arrested. I can only speak for myself. I probably would, said Kitchen, a Charlottesville resident who answered Lee Park when asked for her occupation. I don't think my being here is harmful at any point, except for legal technicalities. I can't see any reason why we should have to be arrested. In a perfect universe, we continue open communication with the police and city council and find a way to work it out so that everyone can get what they feel they need out of this. Kitchen stressed that nonviolence is a key principle of the Occupy movement and explained why she feels it's important to maintain an ongoing presence in the park. A lot of people have said in order to have the movement, you don't need to be in the physical space, Kitchen said. My answer to that is, before we were occupying Lee Park, we had pretty much all of the same options for actions that we did after occupying the park. The only difference is now that we're occupying the park. We have a greater sense of community, we have a base of operations, and we have a visibility for a lot of the problems that need to be fixed. City Police Captain Brian Bibb confirmed that a meeting occurred Wednesday, which he said was one of the many that have taken place since the occupation began in mid-October. Bibb said the department's main goal is to keep everyone safe, including the activists in the Occupy movement. There were discussions about different factions within the movement and how not everyone has the same goals about the occupation, how the occupation should end. I did take from the meeting that there's a difference of opinion on who wanted to leave and how they wanted to leave and whether or not some of them ultimately even wanted to leave on their own. That's certainly a possibility, I would say, that some of the group may not plan to leave on their own. We would, of course, like to see it end peacefully. I think it's a cooperative venture between the protests and the city government up to this point. Knappenberger, an Albemarle High School graduate and anti-war activist who currently lives in Seattle suburb of Bellingham, Washington, said he's been in Central Virginia on a six-week trip to visit his mother, but he's not heading home. But he's heading home in a week. He said the subgroup held a private meeting Tuesday night, which he was not invited to, and insisted on accompanying him when he met the police Wednesday. The claim was, oh, that's because you're leaving. You won't be here when we decide to get arrested, which is true. I'm leaving next week, Knappenberger said, adding that the Occupy movement is supposed to be open and reject secrecy. Knappenberger said the local occupiers are wonderful, beautiful people who put in a lot of time and effort in Lee Park building the movement, but not everyone shares his vision of the occupation as a long-term, well-planned push. This is the first time in their life they felt community, and it's huge, and they don't want to lose that. But at the same time, most of them are inexperienced, and they weren't around when we negotiated the permits, and we talked to the police the first 3 days before we start camping, and they just don't understand the process. The idea is to do it right, and we really want to do it right. We want to do it right for the city. We want to do it right for the community. Nobody wants to see Lee Park turn into a messy hovel. Hobble. City officials said the situation in Lee Park remains fluid and that the permit could be revisited in the events of violation of the law or the permitting process. Mayor Dave Norris has said he expects significant pushback from Lee Park neighbors if the occupiers try to stay past their permit. If the city has to make a decision, it will likely result from a joint discussion between the city staff, and the police chief. If the occupiers stay past the permit and refuse to leave the park, I'm sure Chief Longo will work with the city leaders to construct an action plan that will serve the public interest and ensure public safety, says the bib.
Amen.
Thanks for reading.
Thank you for reading that, Zach.